Zoax.net, Lesson 2, Paragraphs. As we saw, we can add text to the body tag to get the browser to display it. However, there was a problem with this in that the text always appears as a single line. In this lesson, we will demonstrate how to create paragraphs to give the text structure. A paragraph element is specified by using p tags. To make a paragraph, we put the start p tag before the paragraph text and an ending tag at the end of the text. To understand the difference between the text inside the p element and the text outside the p element, consider this example. Here we have two lines of text outside the p element and one line inside the p element. When we open this document, we see that the first two lines of the text have been pushed into one line. This is because all white space is reduced to a single space, as we saw before. However, the third line of text appears on a new line. This is because the p element signals to the browser that it should make a new paragraph out of the text inside the element. The p, or paragraph element, is known as a block element. Block elements create their own separate line. So if we move the second line of text to the other side of the paragraph element, we see that each line of text is on its own line. This is the nature of a block element. It forms its own line. In fact, it makes its own block that looks like this on the page. We can use multiple paragraph elements to form multiple paragraphs like this. In this example, each paragraph element forms its own block and hence its own line. The blocks look like this around the elements. Notice that the blocks have quite a bit of space between them. This space is used to naturally space the elements to make them more readable, and it is called the margin. There's another much smaller space that sits between the text and the border box, and this is called the padding. Block elements have both a margin and padding, and we will examine other examples of this as they come up. This next HTML file shows a more realistic example of paragraph usage. In this example, we have three full paragraphs of text, each in their own element. This is a more common usage. Again, we can render this, and we see a more typical example of text laid out in paragraphs. We can show the boxes around the block elements to see how these block elements hold several lines of wrapped text. The text inside a block element naturally gets wrapped onto the next line, and all of the text inside the paragraph element sits in a single block as shown here. Again, we see the margins and the padding as before. Within a paragraph element, white space is treated exactly as it was before and is reduced to a single space. So this example code is reduced to a single line of text.